Rituraj Sinha, great to have you on The Big Idea. Thank you for taking time out. And this is a very good place. It reminds me of Gurgaon, but this is Noida. I must add it. Okay, let's share with us. Rituraj, your story is pretty unique. You had a great professional career at Halifax Bank. But you came back. Why?
Well, I mean, honestly, I, through my years at university, wanted to be a banker. So I approached the whole career with that idea that I wanted to be in an investment bank and work for a bit in the banking space. But then that was around the 2002 period, and 9/11 had just happened, and suddenly one realized that security sector.
Yes. Yeah,
security sector after 9/11 became hot, and things were happening, and there was a discussion point everywhere across the world. So, you know, the idea came about, why don't I go back home and try and do something that's
so big. That's actually what the pivotal reason was, ki aap wapas aaya. Acha, jab aap wapas aaya and you took over Securities Intelligence Services, SIS, wo initial jo period tha, kya kya challenges aapne face kiya?
Well, security sector has evolved tremendously in the last 15 years. So when I got involved in 2001, 2003, in that initial years, private security in terms of service content was still evolving.
Mom and pop, little.
Not mom and pop, the function that the guard performed has gone from just a basic chowkidar to somebody now who is outside, you know, like a Delhi metro or a Bangalore metro, who's, you know, doing frisking and x-ray machines
and
CCTV cameras and stuff like that. So the function that the guard performs has evolved. Now not all of it has evolved. The more organized companies are sort of taking on work which is more professional and more demanding in terms of job roles that a guard performs, while there is the laggard end of the industry which still continues to do chowkidari.
Okay, so that's
it's an evolving sector.
Transition has taken place. If you jump on the bandwidth where you're doing more than just the chowkidari, so the sky's the limit, I guess.
I think my point is well established through, you know, one or two just simple indicators. In 2004, this sector was $1 billion.
Okay.
5,000 crore approximately. In 2018, the private security sector would be $10 billion, more than 65,000 crores.
My God.
So the exponential growth in the space
is astronomical.
You know, it's all around you. I mean, I personally tell everybody that, you know, what is the opportunity in the sector? I mean, it's this sector is omnipresent. It's aap hamare char or hai. Agar aap subah se apna schedule khud dekhen. आपके हाउसिंग सोसाइटी के बाहर आपको गार्ड दिखे होंगे
ठीक है
अगर आप अपने बच्चों को स्कूल छोड़ने गई होंगी वहां पे गार्ड दिखे होंगे आपको आते जाते ऑफिस मार्केट्स में आपके ऑफिस में सिक्योरिटी है जहां जाएंगे वहां पे कैमरास होंगे और जब सड़क पे आप मूव कर रही होंगी तो आपको कहीं ना कहीं कैश वैन्स जरूर
दिखेंगे
आप एटीएम में पैसा निकालने जाएंगे
वहां
पे सिक्योरिटी भी होगी कैमरा भी होगा और पीछे से कैश वैन कंपनी कैश इंजेक्ट करती है तभी आप कैश निकालते हैं
सो ऋतुराज आप जो कह रहे हैं ये बिल्कुल सही है
इट्स अ बेसिक नेसेसिटी
जहां आप जाओगे आप देखोगे सो व्हेन यू केम बैक आपके क्या-क्या आइडियाज था टू ऑब्वियसली मेक इट द ट्रांजिशन फ्रॉम अ चौकीदारी टू दिस काइंड ऑफ एजेंट
प्लेटफॉर्म वेल आई थिंक द इंडस्ट्री हैज इवॉल्वड एंड एसआईएस हैज इवॉल्वड
हां
सो वी वर इन अर्ली 2000 एसआईएस वाज अ गार्ड्स कंपनी From there, we went to a total security solution provider. We added cash management, right? We added, you know, electronic security. We added cash management. We added these arms. And in the last 5 odd years, we have strived to go from a total security company now towards a business support services.
B2B services, yeah, which I will discuss with you a little later. Initially, when you were expanding, because 20 साल के अंदर यू रियली ग्रोन एक्सपोनेंशियली फंडिंग कैसे मिला हाउ डिड यू मैनेज टू
वेल आई एसआईएस वाज द फर्स्ट कंपनी इन द प्राइवेट सिक्योरिटी स्पेस टू रेज प्राइवेट इक्विटी मनी So in 2007, we raised money from D. Shaw,
correct,
private equity. And
it's
now
now
we have CX Partners,
okay,
as a private equity investor.
Huh.
But having said that, I mean, the beauty about this business services, security services space, yeah, is the incremental equity required,
huh,
for growth, huh, is fairly small. It's a very capital light model.
Correct.
So
not
what
heavy expenditure.
So what the beauty about this business is that it's recurring revenues.
Hmm.
It's not very capital intensive.
Hmm.
It throws up a good amount of free cash flow, and it then becomes self-funding. Therefore, from an investor or an entrepreneur perspective,
yeah,
it is extremely attractive from a return on capital employed or return on equity perspective.
Very interesting. I want to ask you, it's the back end ka jo hai, SIS mein. I think it's very, very important in terms of the type of quality of people you have working in terms of guards, verifications. Ye hamare saath share kar lijiye, how it all works. It's very fascinating.
I think any service business,
huh,
is all about evolving the service content.
Correct.
And making it uniform and consistent across.
Yeah.
So we try and do the basics right.
Uh-huh.
There is a Private Security Agency Regulation Act that lays down some basic norms,
okay,
for how a security guard should be trained, how he
should... government norms.
There are some, uh-huh, government norms.
Okay.
But then how you differentiate is how you build on that. Like, for example, everybody
yeah,
recruits guards, right? Guards, uh-huh, are my raw material.
Yeah, exactly.
They are also my
chocolate
product.
Daddy is your raw material.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So,
I like
so the manpower that we provide, you know, can look like a chokidar, uh-huh, can also look like a sophisticated guard outside of a DLF Emporio mall.
Uh-huh.
Right? Or an Oberoi hotel.
Yeah.
The difference, uh-huh, is three things.
Uh-huh.
How you recruit,
uh-huh,
how you train and skill them,
uh-huh,
and how you manage day-to-day operations for quality consistency. So what we've managed to do is,
mm-hmm,
all these three critical elements that, mm-hmm, define my service content,
mm-hmm,
we have put this on a absolutely technology-based platform. So today, if you go to a SIS recruitment facility,
okay,
it will look very much like a passport seva kendra, because it electronically does all your measurements,
uh-huh,
it scans all your documents, it takes your test on a mock interview, which is recorded, uh-huh, under video. It checks you for
Soch
the basic skills.
Sakta ke technology, right? Ki zarurat hai is sector mein.
You should probably come and see our training, you know, recruitment facility.
No, we definitely have to take visual,
right,
footage of this.
Absolutely.
It's sounding incredible.
So I think that I think must be highlighted, because what that does is that today SIS is able to tell you that what is the average height of my 103,000 employees across India. What is the average qualification?
I don't believe
it. I could tell you who's
That's
the...
That's why you're saying passport.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
Who's the shortest guard? Who's the tallest guard? What is the average age?
Under your banner, SIS banner?
SIS group has a total of 110,000 permanent staff. 103,800 are in India.
Huh.
And the rest are in Australia.
I do have to add in, Rituraj Sinha, that when you were working in Halifax Bank and you came back, you have really grown the company exponentially. You can't think about it so quickly, you know, you would have such a growth spurt. It could not have been easy. Asani ho nahi sakta. Kaise kiya?
Well, I think I've been very fortunate, mm-hmm, in that sense, because I landed up in the security industry just at the right time,
huh,
when things were sort of starting
very
to
required,
evolve.
Very required, I guess.
Yeah. So the demand was going very well.
Huh.
And second, I think SIS as a platform that was set up by my father in 1974. Was a very strong platform, and the people who were there in the business, the real kisi bhi service company ka jo strength hai, wo uske log hai. Aur in 2002 SIS revenue terms mein choti company bhale ho, par quality of managers ke roop mein bahut mazboot company thi. To basically un logo ka effort hai, un logo ki mehnat hai, jo jisne ek 25 crore ki company ko ek 4000 crore ki company banaya.
Fantastic. I mean, it's insane. Now, jaisa aap bol rahe ho ki Australia mein bhi hai, wo you branched out there as well.
Well, SIS is the first Indian multinational in security services space.
Correct.
So, just in 2008, we went and acquired Australia's largest security company. So today, in Asia-Pacific region, we are number two in terms of revenue.
Correct.
Roughly $750 million, all put together. In the global ranking table, we are number 11 in terms of size.
Globally?
Globally. So it's a great example of what you can do in India.
A made in India brand.
It is.
These days, I'm doing this big idea with just made in India brands.
This is a made in India brand.
Incredible. I mean, what would you say? What would you attribute to the success, the phenomenal trajectory of SIS? In terms of your involvement, abhi tak kitne young,
I think the limit. I think, you know, I could speak for my business. I think what we have taken to the world in terms of our Australia venture, and after that we've had three global joint ventures and partnerships in the last so many years. I think what SIS has been able to demonstrate, and I think what India brings to the table, is more hard-working managers than probably anywhere you could get. India's greatest blessing and India's greatest asset is its people. And I agree so much with our Prime Minister every time he talks about the Skill India program. If we equip our people, whether he's a worker or a manager, with the right skills, anything is possible, and that's been demonstrated. I mean, today, it is our team in India which will at some point in time venture out into other countries in Southeast Asia and lead businesses in those countries. So I think the quality of management that we have is at par with the best in the world.
हमारे साथ share कर लीजिए, बहुत सारे verticals actually हैं अभी SIS banner में.
So SIS does end-to-end business support services.
अच्छा, ये exactly क्या है?
So business support services starts with something like security, which is your man guarding, electronic security, cash management, and then it also gets into the business support services area. So we have companies called Service Master, which is a facility management company which does cleaning and maintenance and all that. And then we have
cleaning and maintenance, then it's not security as per se.
That's why it's business support services.
Okay.
So we ventured from total security solution provider to a business services
Platform.
We have a joint venture with the world's largest pest control company, Terminix US. So today SIS is a group of 8 subsidiaries, each one pursuing a separate vertical within the business support services space. So it's all these 8 companies put together that make us a platform which operates across 560 districts in India, largest service delivery network.
Where all? Which cities?
So it is from Imphal, we have a branch to Jamnagar in Gujarat, and from Jammu up north to Kochi. So you know, SIS branches are spread across. In a city like Delhi or Bangalore or Mumbai, SIS would have 15 to 20 branches of all these businesses put together. So there'll be 10 guarding branches, 2 cash branches, there'll be pest control branches, cleaning branches.
Fantastic, huh? How you've grown in the last 15 years.
So it's simply about encircling the
the
customer and the opportunity. So when you set up a business, or whether it's a factory, plant, or a small office, you are very likely to hire some kind of security. You are likely to buy some cameras. You would want some cleaning support and stuff.
Exactly.
You will need pest control. Right?
These are all the basic requirements in India.
So that's why it's called business support services, because it sort of encircles.
A to Z, encircles.
And it encircles the customer. And I think the essential part also is that now that there's so much talk about make in India.
Correct.
Even Swachh Bharat. These programs are directly affecting demand generation for our sectors. So more infrastructure spend, infrastructure spend, more construction, more factories, more production, more startups.
Sky's the limit, exactly, more startups.